Hello, flower friends, and welcome back to my flower world. I'm Kristen Griffith-VanderYacht, and today we are going to be talking about my favorite flower, my absolute favorite flower, hellebores! Okay, so these are actually from my garden. I know, me, a green thumb. Who would have thought? Yes, but it's true. It's very true. I want to tell you how to maximize the vase life for your hellebore. So what you should be looking for if you're growing your hellebores is you want to make sure that they have a seed pod. That's this little moment right here. So all the pollen has fallen off of the flower and that it has a nice, hardy, protuberous seed pod that is, you know, presenting itself ever so gently. And that's how you know that the flower is actually ready to be cut and harvested. If you cut it before then, your vase life is gonna be like this. It's gonna be super short. Now, if you're a florist and you're used to seeing hellebore in the flower market, and every time you get them back to your shop or your studio, they're always wilting, that's because you picked the wrong bunch. You want to pick the hellebores that have thicker, more waxy leaves. And again, look for the ones that don't have a lot of pollen on them. I know naturally we think, oh, nature, pollen, beauty, it's giving back to the earth. Wrong. No, you want to pick the ones that look super hardy, super thick, super waxy. And that's how you'll get the most out of your flowers. The season that hellebores grow, if you're growing them in the garden, you're gonna start to see them popping up anywhere between, you know, the beginning of February through early spring. If you are buying them at the flower market, and if your, you know, market man or market woman has that hookup, you could even start seeing them as early as January or even December. But don't trust it. Don't trust it, because I've been there and I've made the mistake of buying the hellebores that are so beautiful, that have all this beautiful ruffly pollen all over them. Eh, no. I took them home, I cut them, and they went meow. They pooped out. And it's not your fault. It's just they're being harvested too soon. So the key is patience, taking them out at the right time, and cutting them. They want to take in a lot of water. So when you're cutting them, I even suggest cutting them under water. So when you get them home from the market, put them in a tub or put them in your sink that is full of cold water, and cutting them under the water so there's no sort of air bubbles that can get into the tissue, and then transferring them immediately into more cold water. And then putting them in your cooler or putting them in a super cold, dark place until you're ready to use them in an arrangement. They should last, when they're right, at least, you know, 7 to 10 days in the vase. So good luck. Please leave me, you know, how it works out for you in the comments. I would love, love, love to hear how it works. And if you like the video, please hit the subscribe button and give us a thumbs up. All right, until next time, flower friends. Bye-bye.